रेल म्यूजियम एट भुवनेश्वर।
Was a dream for us. Why? Because a lot of people do not know how old the railway system in this part of the country in Odisha has been. The general impression is that East Coast Railway came up in 1993-97. Before that, some lines used to run. But the name East Coast Railway is more than a century old, and it is one of the oldest railway systems constructed by the British people in Odisha. The Rail Museum, Kalinga Rail Museum, displays how the railway system in India has evolved, how the engines have evolved, how coaches have evolved, how wagons have evolved, how the signal systems have evolved, how the guard and station master's equipment has evolved, how the uniforms have changed of railway staff. It is a very historical place to visit, and I must congratulate the team which has created this museum. They have worked very hard collecting artifacts from all over. To bring it them to this place must have been a Herculean task and a very time-consuming task. My congratulations to this team. A big round of applause for the team. I am sure that this museum will be a very good place to visit for the students, for the citizens of Odisha. People who visit this area to see how the railway system was there in this part of the country. I wish this museum a grand success, and I hope that it will be having so many footfalls that they may have to expand the place. Thank you.
Sir, what is the motto behind this initiative?
The motto behind the Kalinga Rail Museum is that the people of Odisha should know, the children should get educated. As part of their education, they should know what Odisha, how railway has evolved in this country, and especially in Odisha. And this another motto was that the senior citizens who are amongst us today, they should see that how the railway of their time used to look and how the modern systems look, the difference, the progress made by Indian Railways, the progress made by this country is visible in this museum.
Sir, to build such type of museum is a time consuming.
Yes.
But you completed it within 10 months. How can
you? You see, the people have worked very hard. Normally we have a concept that people work in daytime, they work 8 hours, 10 hours. But I can tell you, whenever I review this project, the team of officers, the team of staff, they have worked literally day and night. The contractors have worked day and night. That is how this has come up, and the officers devoted themselves wholeheartedly, monitoring every stage of work done at every point of time. That is how the time got compressed.
How much you have invested in this project?
You see, the investment total would be collated later, but the building was old. We repurposed this building by shifting the work which was being done here elsewhere. So that was the major part of expenditure which we saved. The artifacts we have all collected from various parts of India, various parts of Odisha, various parts of East Coast Railway. So we did not have to pay for them. We only spent money to polish them, to paint them, to brush them up, and to install them in the mode in which they are being displayed. So the expenditure was not very much.
Would you think to extend these types of railway museum in other parts of the East Coast Railway?
If we find, we can locate artifacts, we may like to develop it in other divisions, at least another museum, so that people, the children, especially the elderly, who cannot visit this museum, they can have access to a museum nearer to where they are. But first we will have to complete this project. A lot more artifacts are needing to be displayed. We have got them. A lot more aesthetic changes are in process. You will find this place much more beautiful, perhaps after another, within 2-3 weeks, because some things have yet to come in. So this is, I would say this is only the beginning of a very important, a very big, a very attractive and a very aesthetic project.
Sir, is this the first museum in country, rail museum?
No, this is not the first rail museum in country. There are some rail museums in this country elsewhere. But we were very unhappy in East Coast Railway that in East Coast Railway, in this part of the country, in the coastal area, there was no rail museum. And so we decided we will make a rail museum which will encompass the story of not only East Coast Railway territory, but the entire country's territory. And we are happy that we took this project, and the people understood the motto, they accepted the motto and created history. They created this place.